On July 26th, at 36 weeks, 4 days pregnant, I went to the doctor for an ultrasound. At that appointment, our new baby was diagnosed with a terminal birth defect, anencephaly. We were told that he may not be born alive, and if he were, he may live only a few minutes. He wouldn't have part of his brain, and his skull wouldn't be covered. I decided to induce the following day, in the evening after attending a fundraiser my older children were performing in. On Wednesday, the 27th, we decided we would name our new baby Poe Elijah, Elijah being the guardian of newborns and those who die at an early age. We told the brothers and let them say goodbye to the brother in my belly. We didn't know if they would get a chance to meet him. We went to the fundraiser, then I went to the hospital to be induced. At first, I was in a tiny corner room. They thought it would be kinder to me to keep me out of the way of the other babies. At nurse shift change, my new nurse moved me into a lovely normal room. It was still going, getting started, so the next morning the boys were able to visit me for a few minutes. That evening, at 4:57 p.m., Poe was born. Like all babies, he was beautiful and perfect, and we told him so. He struggled to breathe at first, but he was alive, with a strong heartbeat. They put him directly on me without doing the newborn testing or suctioning that was not necessary in his case. We had been told they would take no extraordinary measures. Minutes passed, and though he seemed to forget to breathe occasionally, he would start again. The minutes turned into over an hour, and we decided to get the brothers rushed up to the hospital so they could meet their newest brother. They made it, and it was precious. Poe showed them that he had learned from them, displaying massive courage, strength, determination, and love. His breathing became easier. His color got pinker. After the visit, the brothers said goodbye to their much-loved new brother and were taken home. Poe lived for another 2.5 hours. At the end, the difficulty breathing just got to be too much. We held him as he peacefully struggled to get breath, one or two in every few minutes. Eventually, the breathing stopped. Then several minutes later, at 11:17 p.m., his heart stopped and he was gone. He lived a miraculous 6 hours and 20 minutes. We held him close for another few hours, wondering at this gift that we had been given, to be the parents of one who would only know love and acceptance in his short life. We know his story has touched not only us, but hundreds who have reached out to us with love and support. Let his life be a reminder to all who he touched about love, acceptance, and understanding. If you see him in the street, walking by your side, talking by your side, have pity.
Eliza, do you like it uptown? It's quiet uptown.
He is trying to do the unimaginable. See them walking in the park, long after dark, taking in the sights of the city.
Look around, look around, Eliza.
They are trying to do the unimaginable.
There are moments that the words don't reach. There's a grace too powerful to name. We push away what we can never understand. We push away the unimaginable. They are standing in the garden, Alexander by Eliza's side. She takes his hand. It's quiet uptown.
Forgiveness. Can you imagine forgiveness? Can you imagine? If you see him in the street, walking by your side, talking by your side, have pity. They are going through the unimaginable.
It's hard at the end of the day. I need some distraction. Oh, beautiful release. Memories seep from my veins.
so brave. You're trying so hard. I know. Look at you moving. Look at you moving. What a brave boy. What a brave boy. What a brave boy. I can't believe it. How brave and strong you are. You haven't breathed in. And you still have a heartbeat. How is that possible? And now you've closed your eyes. You're getting ready to go to the big long sleep. We love you so much. It's okay. It's okay, Poe. You were so generous with your time today. Such a sweet little guy.